fog settled into the valley, into perspiration running down Kalora's face. The raven's last cry echoed from the ledges above and quieted with the night. Morning broke, hanging purple in the valley. The shadow of the white crane stood on the mountain, blue heron by the shore, fish-beaked and still. The loon's call reached out, breaking the stained glass imagined in water and sky. Blind old Kalora rose to follow the loon's call, its alluring silence. Dreamed from the days of summer the long shades of autumn trees. Watched in the winter sun the Nicola River wash away its banks into spring. Into his dreams the loon called, and seized with the restlessness of a thousand children, his hands fumbled, seizing in turn the stick at his side. What stained, half-starved, Kalora always returned, only to say he had been to speak with the loon. Winter came, after a long wet autumn. The wind blew, long and black. There wasn't time to dry the berries harvested. The deer, the grouse, the rabbit were gone. Like the days of summer, the salmon dried and lay by, were devoured too fast, too soon. The lone wolf now stood on the mountain, black shadow in the wood. The hunter became the hunted, endless night at the lodge door. Children in the belly of darkness, the hunter no longer hunted. The village became gray-eyed and feared for its life. Kalora, with his dreams, was shunned and sent away. Go back to your medicine-making and listen now for the call of your loon. The night came, stood cold and clear. Through the tangle of naked branch, the wind swirled, biting the corner of the eye. The silver streaks of Kalora's hair blew aurora borealis in the night sky. Rising, he went into the sweat lodge. The loon weaved in and out of the old man's mind. Kalora, the winter will come early and stay too long. The wolves will be hungry. Game will be scarce, fear for the children. Outside, the wind shifted, and with them the image of the loon. His wife's stinging words returned. Kalora, you blind old fool, you're good for little enough. You and your loon, you and your dreams, you're a burden to me in the world. 4 days he fasted. 4 days he returned to the sweat lodge. Each time only to plunge into the icy waters of the Nicola River. About his neck, in a sacred manner placed, a collar of white dentalium shells, gathered in distant childhood, small white shells. Small, eager hands, in a sacred manner placed, sunlight in the shadowed wood. With morning, Kalora called to his wife, bring me now my bow. And walking to the edge of the village, amidst the village mockery, fitting the arrow to the sinew, saying, point me at the largest wolf, the arrow will fly true. The dream broken, the loon once more entered the valley of his mind. The winter had passed into spring. Life had returned. Kalora, medicine man, following familiar paths, felt the cool, clear water washing his feet, recognizing in that instant the home of his teacher. Kalora spoke. Come to me now and speak to a blind old fool. The loon came into the first wave but did not speak. Come to me now and speak to a blind old fool. Close by his feet, the loon answered, all I hear is the sound of the dying wind. I have come to ask, to beg you return my sight. In your power there is hope. Sight may be found in many ways in this world. I seek the sight of men. Look to yourself for your vision. But I am blind, and this is why I have come." So with a sad laugh echoing from the ledges, the loon replied, "Climb then upon my back." Kilor waded out, awkwardly seated himself upon the loon's back. Below the surface of the water the pair went. And when they rose again to the light of day, the loon questioned, "Tell me, what do you see now?" Kilor replied, "The world is but a gray haze." Once more they entered the depths of the lake, and when they returned to the surface, the loon asked, "Kilora, what do you see now?" "I see fog upon the water and the motion of the wind." Twice more the loon and his rider entered the depths of the lake, and the fourth time the world revealed itself to the eyes of the old man, and where the sun set brightly in the west, Kilora waded ashore, leaving his weary companion. Reaching it, he turned and gazed back across the water, but all he saw was a small black head of a bird bobbing in the waves.
The lonely call of the loon filling the valley echoes from the cliffs and hills, only touching the sadness of men who are able to know its meaning. Taking the necklace of dentalium shells from about his neck, tossing them about the loon's neck, they, spinning, broke, spilling down its back.